I'll never forget a teacher tell my mom that I wasn't high school material. After a series of events, a lot of fighting, a lot of struggling, that school ended up kicking me out. The next year, I went to another school, and because I did not do well and I did not put good in, when I got that final report card, all Fs, one C. But I came up with a plan. I said, you know what, I'm gonna change my grades. So I went to the library, I got that whiteout, I brushed off all the Fs and the C, I took a fancy pen and a ruler, and I put those small little dots and lines, and I gave myself all A's and two B's. At the end of that summer, when my real report card came in, it was really rough. I'll never forget, like, when I first tricked my mom and she saw it, she was like, I'm so proud of you. She started crying. She hugging me, I'm hugging her. We got like a breakthrough. And you're probably wondering, like, Jeremy, why were you crying? Like, you know you didn't really earn all A's and two B's. Well, for the first time in a long time, I didn't feel like a failure. Like, I actually felt successful, like, worthy. Like, I felt like I was good enough. And so that was a bit of an emotional moment. But it wasn't real because I didn't really earn those grades. Now, when my school sent my real report card home and my mom saw it, she was in denial. My baby made A's and B's. So she called the school. And again, she's in tears. But now what was once tears of joy, now it's tears of sorrow, tears of pain, tears of frustration. And she's trying to figure out, like, I wish my baby would just get it together. And I was so hurt, but I felt stuck. And my mom's a great mom, so she moved me to another school. And I don't know how to explain it to you, but I got a group of teachers, I felt like they were weird. They were saying stuff like, Jeremy, we believe in you. And they began to speak life to me. They began to encourage me. They began to affirm me. And because I was young and I was immature, I kind of felt like, well, you don't really understand my story. You don't come from where I come from. And I try to build a wall up. But you know what knocked that wall down? It's love. You know what knocked that wall down? It was perseverance. You know what knocked that wall down? It was like unwavering commitment and support. And I realized you can be black, white, purple, blue, green. We need each other. And if you're showing up because you believe in me and you see great things inside me, like maybe, just maybe I can do great things. And those of you that feel like you're in a really weird place, those of you that feel like nobody understands you, don't keep it to yourself. The worst thing that you can do when you're in that dark place is to just let that thing push you off in the corner. I'm gonna challenge you to come to the light and be bold and be brave enough and be vulnerable enough to say, hey, you know what? I need help. I can't do this by myself. And while you're trying to navigate these waters, you still got the power to save somebody else's life. You got the power to speak up for others. You can make a difference. You can save somebody's life right now by you just being unapologetically you, and you walking in that calling and you speak life and you affirm and you let others know, I see you and I'm with you and I will hold your hand as you go throughout this journey. And even though I'm struggling, I don't mind fighting on behalf of you, and we're gonna figure this thing out together.